Sima. Isaiah also Sima, that is.
Amen. And also, before I go there, I want to speak to the upcoming musicians. I believe that this program, you have started it because of the upcoming musicians, to help them reach somewhere. So wherever you are, I believe that any upcoming musician, Sister Christabel is hosting me today because of the upcoming musicians, so that they can learn, so that also you can help them through your platform of Mary Nyokonyo Music to go far, to reach far, and also to be seen, because I can see Mary Nyokonyo Official has over 8,000 followers. So that one also will help any upcoming musician outside there to grow in music and also to reach somewhere in life. That is what I believe. So I thank God because of your question. I believe that wherever they are, they have heard of it and they will be coming. I know you will tell them how they will be coming. And I wanted to go back to your question you have asked me about how to encourage the upcoming musicians. I want to encourage them that whatever they are doing, if they are doing it for the Lord, God will never disappoint them. We are really looking deep in music or in singing. There is a song that says, God shall never fail. Men can fail you, but God cannot fail me or you. God cannot fail us, our audience. God cannot fail us. So wherever any upcoming musician is, I want to give a word of encouragement that God is not going to fail you, but only if you're singing a Zion song in Zion, not in Babylon. Because when we look at the Bible in Psalms 137, these Israelites were in captivity. They were in Babylon. They were so weary. So they could not sing a Zion song in a strange land. Look at yourself. Where are you? Are you in Zion? Are you singing a song of Zion in Zion or in Babylon? Nakumbuka kuna siku moja, I went for prayers in the mountain. And the servant of God told me, he knew me by just seeing me. He said, are you Mary? I said, yes, I am. Akaniuliza ya kwamba, wewe ni mwimbaji? Nikamwambia ya, mimi ni mwimbaji. How do you know me? Akaniambia huwa nakuona kwa runinga. I hope I'm not mistaken. Nikamwambia ni ukweli, mimi ni mwimbaji, mtumishi wa Mungu na hudumu katika kitengo cha uimbaji. Akaniambia wewe uimba nyimbo za Zayoni, lakini kuna uwezekano hauimbi Zayoni. Then I asked how. Akaniambia when I look at you, you're not blessed. I said, true man of God, I'm not blessed. I have come here to look for blessings. Akaniambia, waimbaji sio watu wakukuja kuomba baraka. Waimbaji ni watu ambao wanaimba na Mungu anawabariki. Nikauliza kiaje, akaniambia ona mtu kama Daudi. Daudi alikuwa kila wakati ni anamuimbia Mungu wimbo. Hako kwa maombi kila wakati. Kiangalia Zaburi, Zaburi ni nyimbo mtupu. Na alipokuwa akiimba, Daudi ndiye aliyeandalia Solomoni kila kitu cha kujenga hekalu. Kumaanisha utajiri wa Solomoni ulitokana na Daudi. Nikamwambia mtumishi wa Mungu nifanye vipi? Akaniambia ushauri ule nitakupatia ni ya kwamba jichunguze, jiangalie, uone kama uimbaji wako unaimba mahali panafaa. Na kama mahali hapo hapafai, you will struggle the rest of your life. Na mimi wakati nilikuwa kwa mlima, I was praying that the rest of my life is the best of my life. Na ya mtumishi wa Mungu akaniambia, kama hautaimbia Zayoni, you will struggle the rest of your life. Watu wengine watakuwa wanabarikiwa kupitia uimbaji wako, maana wako katika madhabahu yanayofaa. Lakini wewe uta struggle. Nikaanza sasa kumtafuta Mungu. Wakati ule nilikuwa mchanga kiasi, nikaanza kumtafuta Mungu, nikamwambia Mungu nielekeze katika madhabahu yanayofaa. Na hapo ndipo Mungu aliponiinua kiwango ambacho nilifika mahali ambapo dunia mzima kwa runinga ingeweza kuniona, na hata mahali ambapo nimefika leo ya kwamba wafasi ni wengi, wale ambao wananifuata kimziki. Unapata mtu anakuambia ya kwamba Mary, nilipokuona kwa runinga ulifanyika wa baraka kwangu, you were a role model to me, you were somebody that I could look at na nione ya kwamba hata mimi nikifanya vile ambavyo unafanya nitafika mbali. And I really thank God. I want to encourage somebody somewhere ya kwamba unapoimba angalia ni wapi unaimbia. Wewe unaimbia katika madhabahu yale ambayo ni ya Zayoni ama unaimba ukiwa Babiloni? Wacha kuimba ukiwa Babiloni. Ndio mtu akasema kwamba you can be at a right place but a wrong time. At a wrong time. So be at a right place, it also a right time. Na Mungu ataweza kubariki.
All right, you are such a good mentor in music. So our viewers, wherever you are, you can find Mary Nyokonyo through WhatsApp. That is 0790-250-813 0790-250-813 or 0704-076-200 0704-076-200. On Facebook, you can find her in Mary Nyokonyo Official. That is official page on Facebook, Mary Nyokonyo Official. Come and share with her, talk to her. She's such a good mentor and she's going to guide you on how to dwell on God's word, on God's songs, Zion songs, and God is going to lift you. And our prayer, my prayer especially, is that may God help you maintain your name.
Yeah.
A good name which is more desirable than great riches.
Yeah.
And may you receive it in Jesus' name.
I receive it.
So wherever you are, our viewers, maybe you have comments, you can continue writing to us our comments. We are going to read them. If you have a question, please write your question. We are going to answer you. And God is going to bless you. God is going to fulfill your heart desires through Christ Jesus. Not through men, but through Christ Jesus. So my sister, back to you. Kindly explain to us. I've been looking at your page and there are some things I read about you. About music, the way you take music to be.
Mm-hmm.
And what touched me is that your mission is to ensure that souls rejoice when receiving Christ in praise and worship to bring them closer to God. So kindly explain to us, how did you come up with this mission and what led you? Because I believe it is the Spirit of God, because whatever you are speaking about is through the Spirit of God. So how did you get this mission?
You have just said souls rejoice while receive. Praise the Lord. So, praising Zion songs is all about joy. Zion songs bring joy. They bring joy into someone's soul. They make King Saul to receive healing. They bring also healing. So we are here to make many souls rejoice. Kwa sababu gani? Kuna mioyo zile ambazo zinalia. Watu ni watumishi wa Mungu. Wanafanya kazi ya Mungu vizuri kabisa. Ama wana support kazi ya Mungu, lakini hawana furaha. Wanaishi katika utumwa. Wanaishi katika kufinyiliwa, aswa waimbaji. Tuko na makanisa ama madhehema ama madhabahu yale ambayo haya acknowledge uimbaji. Yani unapata mchungaji wakati ambapo wengine wao ni wale ambao wako hata katika runinga, unapata mtumishi wa Mungu ni yeye tu kwenye runinga. Waimbaji hawaonekani mahali popote. Unapata ya kwamba waimbaji ni watu ambao wametengwa, makitengo cha uimbaji kimetengwa. Tungependa ya kwamba uimbaji ulete raha. Na unapoangalia pia katika zile runinga zile ambazo zinainua haswa uimbaji, unapata ya kwamba ile nafasi ya praising and worship inaonekana katika runinga, that church is always lively. There is joy in that church. Na waimbaji pia wana feel like, unajua kuonekana kwa runinga ni kitu kizuri sana. Mataifa yanakuona. Watu wanakuona, hata kama ni YouTube, maana kuna makanisa yale ambayo bado hayajafika katika zile televisheni, lakini yako na YouTube. Yanaonekana kwa YouTube ama Facebook, mtumishi wa Mungu wako na Facebook page. Onyesha pia waimbaji wako. Isikuwe kwamba ni wewe tu. Pia wao watagrow. Na inawaletea pia wao raha. So my mission is this platform that we are beginning today is to bring joy to the upcoming musicians. I want them to be seen all over the world. And I'm believing God that through one's support, whoever that is going to support us, I know one day God will take us even to a television. That is where we are aiming. That is our vision. That one day we are going to reach far. We are going to reach somewhere through our supporters. And I thank God also for those who have already supported us, because to be where we are have people who are standing with us as our supporters. And I am believing, God, that from today we are going to receive more supporters, those who are going to support this ministry or this platform to reach somewhere, because we know that we have many upcoming musicians or gospel ministers who have called us because they wanted today to come, but you will not give them that time, that opportunity, because it's our first time to be on YouTube live under this platform. Na tunaamini Mungu ya kwamba kuanzia Wednesdays ambazo zinakuja, bila ambavyo mnaenda kupanga kwa Mary Nyokonyo Studio, naamini Mungu ya kwamba watakuwa wanakuja. Na yote ile ambayo yako mbali, hizo nambari ambazo dada Christabel amepeana, ni zako wewe kupiga na pia kusupport huu huduma ili tukaweze kufika mbali. Unapopiga najua ya kwamba kuna ma secretaries wetu katika ofisi zetu watakupata na utafika kwenye studio hizi, na utapata pia kuchangia ama kuhamazisha waimbaji wenzako. Maana bila umeuliza swali lako dada yangu, uimbaji ni kitu cha kuleta furaha, sio huzuni. Unapoimba haileti huzuni. Unapoimba inatakana watu wafurahie, watu washangilie, washerekee. Unaona waimbaji wanasema pigia Yesu makofi ama vigelegele kwa Yesu. That is our aim. We are aiming there that we may bring joy to many souls, zile ambazo zinafifia. Hata waimbaji wale ambao wanafifia wanaona ya kwamba hawana mwelekeo. We are here as Mary Nyokonyo to bring joy unto their souls.
Amen. Thank you very much. And my sister, there's a saying that goes that morning doesn't come without a night. In Swahili, asubuhi haiji kabla ya usiku. And I believe that in your life you've had challenges that are making you glow right now. Challenges that pushed you forward to move on, so that today you are viewed, people are looking after you and seeing you as a mentor. So kindly tell us, what were your challenges, things that made you sit alone, maybe with your husband or without him, and cry out loud to Christ, asking him to give you a guide or a way? Have you ever met any challenges in your life?
So many. Not any, but so many. As a minister of God's word, I have really endured a lot. Beyond my age. I can say it's beyond my age. Kwa sababu nikiangalia tunaona ya kwamba labda kuna watu ambao ni wakubwa kuniliko hawajapitia mambo yale ambayo nimepitia. Haswa yale mengi ambayo nimepitia ni kwa sababu ya huduma. Kwa sababu ya huduma. Nimepata kuwa kwa madhabahu mengi, zaidi ya madhabahu matano ama manne, zaidi ya manne yale ambayo nimepata kuhudumu. Na nikikuja kutambua ya kwamba niko na kipawa, vile unajua baba zetu wengine wao wanataka kulalia vipawa za watu ziende mahali, wakati mwingine inakuwa usiku kwangu nakimbia maombi. Maombi zaidi ya mlima imepata kunisaidia. Nimekuwa nikikimbia maombi kwenye milima kuomba Mungu niposa nipate breakthrough. Unapokuja nyumbani, kuna familia inakungojea, kuna watu wanakungojea ya kwamba usimame na wao kwa maombi, na ile hali wewe pia mwenyewe unatafuta mtu ya kwamba asimame na wewe kwa maombi. Wakati mwingine ukiendea wale ambao ni wazazi wa kiroho wakubwa kiasi kukuliko, wanakuambia usililie watu, inakuwa kwamba ni wewe tu na Mungu wako, kwa sababu wakikuona uko kiwango fulani cha maombi, unajua kuomba ama unajua kuimba. Because most of the time I don't just pray, but I praise. Even if I go to the mountains, I don't go there to pray and to cry. I go there to praise my God, because I know in praises I cannot praise amiss, as you said. I cannot praise amiss. I will always praise and God will answer me. So I have had so many nights that even I can't tell, because most of them have passed through. It's because I've passed. Si ya ndoa peke yake, ni madhabahu, huduma, ni kihuduma. Sasa nikiongea, wenda inaweza kuwa kikwazo kwa watumishi wa Mungu, lakini nimepitia usiku nyingi katika maisha yangu.
Okay, I understand you, and I believe that through your nights and your mornings, you've been able to write songs.
Yes.
During that situation. So, during your nights and your mornings, are those times when you are pushed to write a song?
Yes, true.
They are the times that you are pushed to write a song. So, I consent with you, because, by the way, our viewers, wherever you are, upcoming album for Mama Mary Nyokonyo worship song, I just kind of heard it just the other day. Wewe ni Mungu, hakuna kama wewe, and it is a nice song. Wherever you are, please find it. When it is out, we are going to advertise it to you. Get your copy and God is going to bless you. Wherever you are spiritually sick, you are feeling that you are down, God is going to lift you up.
Amen.
And heal you, deliver you, and most of all, fulfill your desires.
Amen.
Concerning the song, the way I heard the message is going to fulfill your desires, because He did it for you.
It's true.
It is possible for Him to do it for anybody wherever you are. It doesn't matter the type of situation that you are in. Any situation with our God, it is possible for Him to heal.
You have just reminded me of the song, Wewe ni Mungu, Hakuna Kama Wewe. You know how God gave me that song? I was passing through a lot. And a friend of mine was in the mountain praying. Then when she was praying for her own, what she was passing through, oh my God, God ministered to her. Go and tell Mama Mary, I am God and there is none like me. That is how the song came about. Yeye ni Mungu na hakuna kama yeye. And again another song says, anaangalia moyo. God sees the heart. Mungu anaangalia moyo wako ulivyo. That is another song also. It's coming.
Okay.
Yeah, it's on the way. It's coming. Ya kwamba Mungu anaangalia moyo wako ulivyo. Haangali appearance, haangali machozi, idadi ya machozi ambayo unatoa. Unaweza kuwa unalia ili watu wakuone. But God sees the heart.
So, just shortly, can you give us just one line of Wewe ni Mungu hakuna kama wewe, for somebody just to hear what is coming up.
Amen. Wewe ni Mungu hakuna kama wewe. Just leave it there. Okay. They will come to hear about it. Yes.
Okay, no problem.
Thank you.
So, our viewers, wherever you are, you've just heard that Mary Nyokonyo's song, another album, is coming out of pure worship, right?
Yeah.
Pure worship
that will make somebody to kneel down for his God.
Okay.
Mana yeye ni Mungu. He is uncomparable God. You cannot compare him. Hautamlinganisha na mwanadamu yeyote. Hautamlinganisha. Yeah.
And briefly from the message, I just overheard your words, and they were going like, God is love. I remember God is love, and without love, you push God away. So, if you have love, you'll be able to love everybody who is around you. No matter the type of situation somebody is, your love is ready to spread to everybody, because salvation is love to mankind, and also taking care of the needy wherever they are. And I believe that your foundation is supposed to be helping the needy.
It is.
Are you doing such kind of activity?
Yeah, we are helping the needy in many ways. Personally, I'm training my girls. I have like five to eight girls. One of them went to deliver, that is why I'm saying 5 to 8 girls. And I'm training them in fashion and design. And also, as Mary Nyokonyo Foundation, we are still gathering. If you have anything that you have and you see that it will help someone else somewhere, just bring it to our office. we have some more things we still are waiting for other people also to bring so that we can go and visit orphanages. Yeah. And also widows, we are going to help them because we have some food in our stores to help the widows. Yeah.
So I believe that you are ready to welcome anybody who is able to be a caregiver.
Yeah, yeah.
Anybody who is ready to stretch a helping hand to the needy, maybe advise them or talk to them. Are you ready to help them?
We are ready as so, Mary Okonyo Foundation.
So kindly give them your numbers so that they may be able to contact you.
Our numbers, as you gave them earlier, are still the same numbers. 0790 250 813 or 0704 07 6200 07 04 07 6200. Those are our our office numbers.
Okay, so our viewers, I believe that you've been through with us through this interview with Mama Mary Nyokonyo, the founder of Mary Nyokonyo Music Foundation. And if at all you'd like to come and see Mama Mary and talk to her, and maybe you have something to ask her, or maybe you have a vision and a mission in your life and you'd like her to mentor you in your life, kindly, you can come through along Juja Road and alight at number 10. And the buses that you can come with are number 46. That is from town, number 32, number 14, and from outer ring, the same buses, 46, 32. From all stops through roundabout stage, you can come through with number 46, 32, alight at number 10 stage, and you're going to find Mama Mary. If you alight there, you can call her through the numbers that she has told you, call her and she's going to pick you, talk to you, guide you, mentor you, whatever thing that you desire her to help you with, she's going to help you because I believe she's ready to be a service to mankind.
Yes, and that is my work always.
Amen.
That is why I'm called Mama. Mm-hmm. Amen.
And so we are grateful, and before we wind up, I'd like to kindly remind everybody that we are in the Lent season, and we'd like you to please tell us, what do you think about the Lent season, how Christ was crucified, he was tortured to death, because we are in that period.
Amen. Just recently, the world was celebrating Valentine. It was all about love. And that love, I believe that through that love, is the love that made Christ Jesus to come and bring mankind back to God. Na tunamshukuru Mwenyezi Mungu ya kwamba kwa sababu ya huo upendo alimwachilia Kristo Yesu ili asulubishwe kwa ajili yetu, auokoe ulimwengu, auregeshe kwa Mwenyezi Mungu, kwa mikono za Mungu. Kwa hivyo sasa hivi hatuko tena kwa mikono ya ulimwengu, tuko kwa mikono ya Mwenyezi Mungu kupitia damu ya Kristo Yesu. Na tunapojiandaa, maana hivi tu karibuni tumesherehekea kuzaliwa kwake, na tunavyoendelea, tunaendelea kwamba tunaendelea kusherehekea kufa na kusulubishwa kwake. Na tunashukuru Mwenyezi Mungu kwamba kila mmoja, wakati ambapo tunaenda kuangalia ile nafasi ya kifo cha mwana wa Mungu, do not just take it for granted. Take it for your lifetime. Ichukulie kwamba ni maisha yako. Maana pale msalabani, Yesu Kristo hakusulubishwa kwa ajili ya uovu wake. Biblia inasema ya kwamba aliyachukua masikitiko yetu, akayatundika, akayashangilia juu ya msalaba. Alipoyashangilia juu ya msalaba, ilikuwa kwamba ni sisi tuokolewe. Aliondoa aibu yetu. And the writing ambayo shetani alikuwa ametuandikia mashitaka mbele za Mungu ya kwamba ona Mary ako hivi, Christabel ako hivi, ona huyu mwimbaji, mashitaka yale ambayo tulikuwa tumepata kama waimbaji. Kwa sababu waimbaji wengi unapata kwamba kuna mwimbaji alianzia kwenye kanisa, ameenda amemalizia duniani. Kwa sababu gani? Sababu ya kwamba hajajua Kristo Yesu ndio mwenye upako, ndio mwenye funguo ya uimbaji. Daudi alipogundua siri ya uimbaji, alimuishia Mungu maisha yake yote. Na ndio maana tunaweza soma katika 1 Samuel, both in 2 Samuel, about how David went on praising God kama mfalme. Na akaandika kitabu cha Zaburi chote kama mfalme, aliyemsifu Mungu na aliyeajibika katika sifa. Alipokuwa anakumbatana ama anakabiliana na Goliath, ilikuwa ni nafasi mzuri sana. Maana alienda pale akisifu, hakuenda pale akiwa anajisifu yeye, alimsifu Mungu wa mbinguni. Akaambia Goliath ya kwamba, wewe unaniijia kwa jiwe, au unaniijia not kwa jiwe, kwa upanga, unaniijia kwa mikuki. Lakini mimi nakukujia kwa jina la Mungu wa majeshi yote ya Israeli. He praised God before the enemy. Na ndio maana Goliath alipata kushindwa kwa jiwe moja tu. Ndio maana tulibaki ya kwamba sisi watumishi wa Mungu wanasema tulipewa mawe ya Daudi. Hata sisi tunapoenda kukabiliana na adui, hatupaswi kwenda tukiwa na hasira. Tunapaswa kwenda na ile hasira takatifu, a holy anger, sio hasira ya mwili, because vita vyetu sio vya lile jiwe la mwili, ni jiwe la kiroho. Kwa hivyo wakati huu ambapo tunaangalia katika kifo na kufufuka kwa Kristo Yesu, tusiangalie kifo tu, haswa tuangalie ufufuo wake. Maana tutakufa na yeye kiroho na pia tufufuke na yeye. Anapofufuliwa hata sisi tunafufuliwa. Na tuangazie jambo hilo kwa umakinifu zaidi. Tusisherekee vile ulimwengu unasherekea.
Amen. There you had a preacher, she is not only a singer, but
Pastor
also a
preacher,
Pastor Mary Nyokonyo. And I am blessed. I believe that viewers, wherever you are blessed. You've heard her message, and we've come to a conclusion to reasons why she sings Zion songs. Because the word of God is in her. She speaks the word of God, and the Spirit of God is with you too. So as this group, the ones that have hosted you, we'd just like to again remind you that may God help you maintain your good name.
Amen.
Which is more desirable,
amen,
than great riches.
Amen.
And if you desire to have a good name, you are going to receive the blessings of God that adds more sorrows.
Amen.
Any comments, wherever you are, you can comment to us and tell us whatever thing that you want to tell us. Any question you want to ask us, and we are going to reply to you. We are going to guide you on way forward. If you want to come and see Mama Mary Nyokonyo, please go to her page, Mary Nyokonyo official page on Facebook, and WhatsApp 0704-076-200, and you are going to find Mama Mary Nyokonyo. Talk to her, and she's going to guide you on how to sing Zion songs. If the Spirit of God dwells in you, you are going to praise the Lord, and He's going to bless you.
Amen.
Amen. So we'll just wind up, and we thank you for being our guest today. And we bless the Lord for you.
Thank you.
A great message you
thank
had
you
for us.
Thank you.
And before we wind up, kindly, I received a question that kindly ask Mama Mary to explain to us or give us a difference of what is the music industry. Because you hear a gospel artist and saying that I'm in music industry. Then after a short period, this person was singing gospel music and has shifted to secular. I'm still saying that I'm in music industry. So what is the meaning of music industry as a saved Christian or singer?
Oh, I believe the one industry is the same as the one company. So in my knowledge, there is nothing like music industry. When the word industry appeared in music, I believe their music lost its focus. Gospel music lost its focus. Because an industry is the same as a company. Somebody owns it. That is why many musicians are receiving worldly rewards. But our reward is from heaven. Our original reward is from heaven. God can call somebody to be your destiny helper and help you and reward you, but not a competition reward. I don't believe in competing in music. I believe in lifting, in music, that God will lift you to His for His own glory, not for your glory. It's for the glory of God. So for me, as Mama Mary Nyokonyo, I don't believe in worldly rewards. I believe in heavenly rewards, because God is going to reward you. The Bible says that he who seeks the Lord, let him seek him, knowing that he is a rewarder of them who diligently seek him. Seek him in praise. He will reward you. He can reward you through men, but you will not compete to be rewarded. We will not compete to be rewarded. God will reward you as you. He will send you help from Zion. He will send you help, because he did it to them that went before us. He did it. He sent them help. And I believe that wherever any upcoming musician or gospel minister is, for me, Mary, I don't believe in worldly rewards. I believe that God will send me help, because he is all in all.
Amen. I agree with you, because God's rewards last forever. They never expire.
Amen.
So we have our viewers here and their comments, and we have Moses Simiu, and Moses Simiu is commenting that watching you, mommy. So you are a mommy of many.
I am. And I told you, a mama.
And she says, well done, and it's
Thank
very
you.
Encouraging to see you live.
Thank
God bless you.
Amen.
And we also have Anthony Ofisi. I don't know where he's watching from, and I think he's very far, because he's saying, God bless you, mama, as you praise God.
Amen.
And somebody also is writing, to God be the glory, be blessed.
Hallelujah.
Sister Mary. Sister Mary looking good. Amen. Glory be to God.
Amen.
May God continue to bless you and uplift you to the higher next level. Sister
Amen.
Mary, that is Lucy Opata.
Amen.
And somebody else is saying, Nancy Mbui, yes Mary, umenena.
Amen.
Unaweza fanya kazi ya Mungu mahali ambapo hapastahili.
It's true.
So you can do God's work where?
I told you about Zion. Zion songs, sing them in Zion. Do not sing Zion songs in Babylon. And how will you know that this is Babylon? You might be singing, you thinking that this is Zion, and yet you are in Babylon. Ruhusu roho wa Mungu apate kukuelekeza. Waimbaji wengi wanaimba tu katika mwili bora. Anasema ya kwamba, leo uimbaji umebamba. Ama leo uimbaji hauja bamba. Kubamba ni nini? Haijakuwa tamu. Oh, kubamba ni haijakuwa tamu. Unajua kuna lugha ile ambayo mnatumia yenye sisi wa mama hatuelewi. Washosho hatuelewi. Hiyo sio generation yetu. Kwa hivyo unapata mwimbaji anasema kwamba leo mwimbaji umebamba, ama leo mwimbaji haujabamba. Mbona haujabamba? Na ili hali ya umwimbi mwanadamu, unaimbia Mungu. Mwimbaji kila wakati unafaa kubamba. Kama kubamba ni kuwa tamu. Uimbaji kila wakati unafaa kuwa tamu. Haufai kukosa kuwa tamu. Kwa hivyo tafuta hayo madhabahu. Kama unaona hausongi mbele, tafadhali fanya uamuzi wa kujisongesha mbele.
Amen. Alice Njisa is saying, umepotea sana dada Mary.
Hapa niko.
So she's there. New album is also coming.
Yes.
New hot album. Only worship. And God is going to bless you.
Pure
Alice.
Worship. Alice. Zion worship.
Amen. So Alice Njisa, you are going to get her new album, and you are going to find her again. Then we have somebody saying, Lillian Jalemba. She's saying that, be blessed, Dada Mary.
Amen.
As you praise God. And a lot of people are still commenting, a lot of likes. And it seems, Mary, you are a celebrity.
I am a mama.
In Christ Jesus.
Amen.
And may God continue uplifting you.
Amen.
And blessing you for the wonderful work.
Amen.
And may he also fulfill your desires. Because everyone who was created by Christ has a vision. And has anything that you want God to do for you. May he do for you. May he bless you. And may he uplift you. As you continue singing Zion songs, may people be delivered.
Amen.
Let it not only be just a fire. May that person who is blind spiritually to see, that person who feels that they are not comforted, may they be comforted. As your new song says, wewe ni Mungu, hakuna kama wewe. When I look at you, I cannot compare you with anything. You are God and God alone.
Amen.
So our viewers, we thank you very much for being with us this evening, wherever you are. May God bless you, uplift you. Whatever thing you touch, may it be blessed. May your comings and your goings be blessed. As you watch Mary Nyokonyo, as you find her in her page, may you be blessed too, and may God uplift you.
Amen.
In everything that you do. God bless you, and bye for now. Bye.
Shalom.
Shalom.
Shalom.